Namaskar. I am Dr. Rajesh Kambayat, Joint Director, Pandit Sundarlal Sharma, Central Institute of Vocational Education in Bhopal. I welcome you all to this introductory video on introduction of pre-vocation in the schools from class 6 to 8 under NISTA. Friends, as you all know, India is fifth largest economy in the world. India is at a very historical juncture where we have the highest number of youth population with us. Today, the average age of Indian is 27.9, which is the youngest population in the world we are having. Government of India has taken many new initiatives, and one of the important initiatives is promoting skills. Promoting skills across the various sectors of our economy. And in order to do so, this particular module is creating the foundation for that one by introducing pre-vocational module. This module will talk about the historical perspective of work-based education. It will also talk about the skill development initiatives in India, then how to integrate the pre-vocational aspect into the general education. And it will also talk about what are the activities the teachers can take to propagate the importance of work, importance of work for the life and the career will be discussed into this module. Mainly this module will focus on three aspects: learning about work, learning through work, and learning for work. Let us understand this one. In order to have more understanding on this one, I have a pleasure to introduce with you. I have two panelists with me. I have Dr. Vinay Swarup Mehrotra.
Namaskar.
He is a professor and head in PSSCIB Bhopal. I have another panelist with me, Dr. R.K. Patel.
Namaskar.
Who is also professor and head in PSSCIB Bhopal. Let's begin the discussion. Let me ask Dr. Mehrotra, can you please tell me what is this pre-vocation?
So, as you rightly said, that the pre-vocational education is the education which is given at the elementary stage, and special focus is from classes 6 to 8. And through this pre-vocational education, we would be imparting work-based activities, which would be integrated with the teaching-learning process. And the students would be doing a lot of activities besides the learning the subject areas like science, language, maths, and other subjects which are being taught. So it's basically an integration of the work-based activities with the teaching learning process and not as a stand-alone process, which we were having as work experience earlier in the schools.
Okay. Can you also tell me what is the main purpose behind introducing pre-vocation into the school system?
So the purpose is to encourage our students to do a lot of activities in the schools or outside the schools so that they get an exposure of what is there in the world of work and how they can relate these learnings, whatever they learn in the school through general education, with the job prospects or the various occupations which are available in the world of work. Okay. So through this pre-vocational education, they get an exposure of the plethora of choices which are available in the world of work. And this will also help them to apply their knowledge as they would be learning a lot of skills through this whole process.
Now, as I understand, this module will be implemented across the schools in India. Can you throw some light that how it will be really implemented into the schools?
So the whole idea behind this is integrate skills with knowledge. So the existing teachers of, say for example, language teacher, maths teacher, science teacher would be teaching these pre-vocational education activities or conducting these activities in schools and into the world of work. So they will be taking the students to the field for field visits, for exposing them to the variety of occupations in the world of work. Through these activities, these teachers would be applying the knowledge of the different subjects that they have been teaching.
I think it will be interesting. As I can understand from you is that the focus will be mainly on undertaking variety of activities, right, using different methods. Am I right?
Right.
So, may I request Dr. Pathak, can you tell me, as a teacher, say for a science teacher, how he can use variety of activities for promoting pre-vocation into the schools?
Very good question, sir. In science, we have teaching different type of the topics. Regarding as a in botany, we are teaching about the different parts of the plant. For example, stems, roots, leaves, flowers, different type of the plant. Simultaneously, we can teach the use of the parts of the plant as a propagation. For example, leaves. So, leaf cutting use as a, what type of the plant is suitable for the leaf cutting for propagation? Which plant is suitable for the roots cutting for propagation? We can teach which type of the cuttings prepare by the plants for the propagation purpose. For we teach about the rose, hibiscus, different type of the plants used as a cuttings. Some bryophyllum used as a leaf cuttings. Some plants used as a root cutting also. So simultaneously, the one activity as a teaching parts of the plant, we can teach although the plants part used as a propagation. For example, in other ways, food science courses, we prepare the snacks or the healthy snack point of view, sprouts. So in the case of sprout preparation, there is a direct related to seed germination, sir. What is the seed germination? Percentage of seed germination, good quality of the seed germination. So good quality of seed germination directly related to the good preparation of the sprouts. So if you prepare the good sprouts, it means directly related to the germination process. So percentage of the germination as well as the types of the germination also. And the what is the contamination found at the time of the germination? So contamination means different type of the microorganism associated or spoil the germination process or the spoil the seeds. All the activities you can easily integrate in the education as well as the work.
Okay. Education. Nice. Can you tell me, say for example, I am a physics teacher,
right,
or suppose I am a language teacher, how can I integrate pre-vocation into my subject?
So I'll take the subject of language.
Okay.
So because as we all are aware that effective communication skills are very important.
Okay.
So the teachers can conduct role plays to develop these kind of communication skills amongst their students. Because we have been teaching languages for years now, and when the students, for example, go for interviews, they are not able to effectively communicate during that interview.
Okay.
So the teachers can tell them about 7 C's.
Okay.
In effective communication skills. So concise, they have to be very precise in their speeches and okay, during the interview. So these are the some of the skills that the language teachers
okay
can
okay
develop. Similarly in science, for example.
In physics, for
example. In physics, for example. They can, when they are teaching about light,
okay,
they can tell their students how to develop paper lamps.
Okay.
For example, so through that activity they can take up some vocation later on.
Okay.
So when they go into class 9, 10th, 11, 12th, they can relate all these activities with the occupations which are there in the world of work. So that is how we assume that when these kinds of activities takes place from classes 6 to 8 as a part of the pre-vocational education, the students would be able to understand what are the different occupational choices available for them in the world of work.
Okay. So if I understood correctly, I think this module is basically helping the student to understand and appreciate the importance of
right
work, understand the importance of skills. It will also help them understand that what are the new prospects they can have for the career.
Definitely.
In the future life when they will finish their school education and
right
all that one. Can you tell me what are the teaching method the teacher can use for promoting pre-vocation into the schools?
That's a very important question, because when it comes to classroom teaching, what we are seeing that the students mainly they learn through lecture methods because the teachers are more comfortable in teaching through lecturing and using blackboards. But in pre-vocational education, they have to conduct a lot of activities. So activity-based learning has to be promoted. Which we also say experiential learning. So we have to promote experiential learning in classroom. Say for example, role plays, games,
mm-hmm,
projects, group discussion. These are some of the activities that they, so students should also be asked to develop portfolios. So whatever they have done, they should include it in their portfolios. So that will encourage them later on, and they, that these portfolios can be showcased to their parents, to the other teachers, that whatever they have done in the school or outside the school. So both off the job and on the job activities have to be conducted so that students get a lot of exposure of the choices that are available to them.
Okay. Dr. Pathak, can you give me an example, say for example, agriculture?
Yeah.
Like it is one of the very important sector of our economy, and suppose students are to be exposed for agriculture related activities while they are studying into the school. Can you give one example for the teachers?
For example, first example, demonstration and field preparation. Any agriculture course you can teach in classroom situation, the field is required. For exposure point of view, for gardening, for identification of plants. So plants, you can teach the students in classroom types of the plants and name of the plants, but how to identify the plants is essential to teach the student outside the classrooms. So different type of the plants available in vicinity of the schools or nearby area. So teacher must demonstrate as well as the field visit organizer. So outside the school campus, different type of the environment, socio-economic environment or social environment condition also helpful to the different type of the learning, as well as the field visit is the important, sir, in case of agriculture, as well as the demonstration point of view, sir.
Okay. So mainly you feel that hands-on practice,
right,
use of demonstration, taking student for the visit will be really helpful to the students,
right,
and all that. Having said all this thing, I'm sure if the student undergo pre-vocational module, there are many qualities a student can develop. There are many benefit I'm sure the student can derive for this pre-vocational module. Can you elaborate what could be the qualities or benefit the student will have from this?
So when we talk about the three domains of learning, which is cognitive domain, psychomotor, and affective.
Okay.
So in affective domain, we have attitude. Now, through these activities, students will develop a lot of positive attitude, and also they will be developing qualities like teamwork, leadership skills, creativity, because that's very important nowadays when it comes to designing things. Because creativity pays a lot nowadays when it comes to innovation or making things in a better shape.
Okay.
So creativity skills would be developed, logical reasoning. These are some of the characters or the values. So dignity of labor, for example,
yeah,
that is also very important.
Yeah, it's very important.
Because when it comes to vocational education, dignity of labor is very important aspect that we need to develop. And Mahatma Gandhi, as we all know, have always talked about working with hands. And he has said that we need to link our head, heart, and mind. And this can happen only when we promote work experience or pre-vocational education program in schools.
Okay.
This is respect of the work also.
Yeah, yeah. This is very, very,
very
important.
Very,
very
respect
important
of
for
the
early. And the early the students are exposed for this one, I'm sure it will be great help to them. Just to summarize our discussion, what will be your suggestion to the teachers? How they can take forward this pre-vocation? What is your suggestion to the teachers who are implementing in these schools?
First, teachers should orient about the concept of the vocational education.
I think this is very important.
Important.
Yes.
First, the orientation is required. That was the commitment.
Yeah, yeah.
The course as well as the vocational education also, and exposure is required. After this exposure and commitment, they can teach very well about the different methods and different types of the activities they can inculcate into general education also, sir.
Okay.
So I would say that teachers are the change agents, and they have to really think of other modes of teaching learning rather than just focusing on through lecture methods and the traditional or conventional kinds of teaching learning. So they have to conduct a lot of activities in the school as well as out of the school. And they should first, as Dr. Pathak has rightly said, they should orient themselves about what are the various aspects of the pre-vocational education that they need to implement effectively in the school. So they should undergo through this module and also understand what are those activities that they can plan throughout the year. So a meticulous planning by the teachers is very essential in order to make effective learning.
Okay.
Through their teachings, whatever they are going to do in the school or outside the school.
Thank you. Friends, as you have seen that this pre-vocational module is going to be implemented for the first time in the country. And that's why it is very, very important that this module is taken in a good spirit. And the focus of this module has to be on the creativity, the innovativeness taken by the teachers. Because this module is actually exposing students for the appreciation for the labor, appreciation of the work in their life. And it will also create the foundation which the students are going to take their future career built on this one. The more details are available on this module. I would request the teachers to go through this module. And I'm also happy to share with you that our institution has developed many vocational curriculums and textbooks which are leading for the higher studies in the vocational education, and it will be of great benefit for the student, exposing them that what are the career choices available to them in the further studies when they enter into class 9 to class 12 and the further education. Thank you very much for your attention, and I hope you will enjoy this module to a great extent. Thank you, my panelists, also for your time and sharing your experience. Thank you.